you. It's Squirrel. Hi. I'm doing makeup for tonight. First things first, I know I put this on earlier, but gonna do it again. Can never have too much deodorant. Ever. Alright. So that's done. Now it. Okay, let me start off with my primer. So, I, as you might have noticed, that some of my videos from before this, they're all TikTok videos. Well, I'm quite popular on TikTok. Sort of. But, I'm not gonna pull these out. Yeah, get off! I've ordered more of the good ones that I'm getting. I've also ordered some that are face wipes, so they're actually good. Alright, so. Basically, I've actually got 2,000 fans on TikTok. You know, which is really fucking awesome for me. That's like, to me, that's awesome. However, a good part of them are children. And it's really upsetting that there's children on there. Because a bunch of these children get offended by anything that is remotely adult. Oh, if you're doing videos with vaping in them, you can get reported. You have alcohol in it, despite being an adult, you can get reported. Having fake weapons, get reported. Little tiny things that apparently offends them is really upsetting. Now, I uploaded all my videos here. Just so that, if anything happens to any of my videos, I have them here. And I will continue to do this every now and then, mostly so that I stop clogging up my phone with all the freaking 10, 11 minute videos. Okay. Anyway. Excuse me. But that's one of the reasons. The other reason is that I'm deleting a good portion of those videos off my TikTok, mostly because they are part of things that I'm kind of doing a bit of a professional restart of my TikTok. That's a bit sticky. Anyway. Why is there a snatch? Oh, it's because I dropped it. That's right. So yeah, I've got, I'm doing a partial professional restart of my TikTok. So all my old AUs are going to get deleted. All the videos with my characters that are my original characters, unless they are part mixed with videos that are the AUs, which is most of them, I also redoing one of the characters, so it doesn't matter. But, William is, I need to really revamp William anyway, give him an official look, which is, I look like a guy, girl, but I'm actually a dude, sort of. So yeah, so, pretty much, here we go, yes, there we go, let's get the corner. Sometimes when I do my foundation, my context shifts weirdly. I like to get into the corners of the eyes. There we go. Alright, so there's my foundation down. Looks a little tan compared to the rest of my skin. Problem is, I'm just really fucking pale. So I pale myself up to my preferred, for me, with a white powder known as Virgin from Manic Panic. I happen to be a goth, and I happen to enjoy looking like fucking Casper. But to anyone that says you have to be pale as fuck to be goth, fuck them. They are racist and need to go jump off a building. Because racism has no part in the gothic community, and fuck anyone that says it does. They are just gatekeeping and trying to keep awesome people out of our community. And they do not belong. And they're just upset that people don't... They're probably... And a lot of those that are like that... Probably, have worn out their welcome in any places that are actually goth venues. Or goth events. And no one wants anything to do with them, so they're the little online warrior keep... You know, keyboard warrior bullshit. Because... Nobody can stand them in real life. Because they're racist. I mean, why would you want to be around people like that, you know? I don't. Jesus Christ, part of my friend circle, friends, is not white. I have people who look white. I have friends that look white, but actually aren't. Because they're part of extreme ethnic minorities. Like a couple of Romani friends. Most of you have no clue what that means. Let's see. Alright, now I'm gonna brush this powder down. Okay. Because I'm sick of Fallout. I'm going to take this. I'm going to carefully tap a little bit. I'm going to... Going to set that there. And now I have to take this powder and get it all off me because it's all over my clothes. Oh boy. It's everywhere. It keeps falling out on top of my skin. It's all over my tools. Like my foundation brush and my brushes. Oh, I fucking hate this powder. Get it off me. All right. So, let me see. I'm gonna quickly do this. See if I can just find the. So I'm just gonna go with my normal. Alright. So, let's see. I'm gonna take. Alright. There are you, beauty. I'm looking for my brush. Found it. This is my angled eyeshadow brush by Elf. Whatever. I don't remember. Got it at Walmart. wanna do this. It's got a weird sheen to it. I'm not gonna use it because it's just not gonna work for what I want. Let's see. Good luck. Yeah, I like the gold better. Okay. So I'm gonna take some gold. So the first color I used is called Tantalizing. It's kind of like a gray gold. It's kind of like a gray more than a black. So prefer it. Now this particular color is called French Kiss. Really trying to layer it on. I'm gonna take, just gonna go back. This is my large laydown brush, and I'm gonna take some more on. I'm gonna take some of the First Kiss on here and actually just really kind of get into that crease. Just so the crease is good. Because I can always go back and add more of the Tantalizing layer. This, I'm just gonna kind of start swiping on here. There we go. So I want it in, and I'll clean up half a mess later. Just gonna get into my hair. I'm gonna take this, just gonna start laying it down into here. Gonna do this. I'm just gonna swipe it over like this. Do this. Just swipe it over like this. There we go. And then, as I'm getting the annoying colors everywhere, I'm gonna take some of the Tantalizing, tap it out, and then just kind of brush back and forth on the lid so it's. Just a little more. There we go. Just on the lid. Okay. No. Just that side. It's too dry. So now, if the white powder has done its job, I can take this and just okay. As you see, it has not done its job because I can see where the nose is. But the nice thing about this is I'm just going to take this and wipe my nose off because I got to redo my nose area anyway. Okay. So yeah, sometimes I have to do this. I hate doing it, but I do. Okay, so I'm going to take... just wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Droop, 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 droop. Same thing about this brush, is it just really can easily. So, yeah. So then I go back in with the white powder. And I just. So I'll take the French kiss and just kind of softly bring it back out. There we go. Okay, so there's the eyeshadow done. I actually wasn't going to go for something major. I had no desire to go for something major today. All powder all off my everywhere else. Okay. So now I'm gonna take I'm gonna take this matte black lace palette, grab my contour brush and start contouring. Now this time, I'm kind of going for a very slim nose. Oops. You notice that I'm contouring with gray. Well, the truth of the matter is, when I try and contour with brown shades, they all either, in order for me to actually look contoured, in order for my contour to actually look right, I have to use something darker than what I, you know, something pretty dark, but then it doesn't look right anymore. Unfortunately, I am bound to the curse of, I'm pale as fuck. Because of this, and this is just me trying to get the contour down. now I'm taking a Bone by NYX. This is one of their contour and shading, one of their contour and shade things. Take this little brush. And because I'm going for more of a grunge look, I'm not concerned with looking too I'm gonna take the white powder. I'm just gonna carefully brush it, like use the powder brush to actually brush over all my makeup. This helps soften pretty much anything I've done. Okay. Now to do the annoying part. Okay. There. Here's the fun part. The lashes. My eyeliner. Yeah, you notice that I'm putting mascara in my eyebrows. Well, that's because a lot of the eyebrow colors and the eyebrow wands and stuff, they don't go dark enough, and so my eyebrows still look bleached when for my makeup, and they don't blend right. Like, my eyebrows actually match my hair, look more like they match my hair than any of the shades of brown do, because I've just got that dark brown hair. It's like, yeah, no, you have brown hair, but if I don't use the black, it doesn't look right. I look like my hair is dyed, and it's annoying. The only time I put another color in my eyebrows is this one. It's blue, and that's because I do Sal Fisher, and, you know, of course Sal's gonna have blue eyebrows. I mean, his hair is blue. And so does dad's. Like, his dad's eyebrows and beard are blue. Like, everything about his dad is, like, blue. It's, like, you're all blue. It's, like, yeah. So, like, of course, if his dad has blue eyebrows and a hair and beard, then, obviously, Sal's gonna have the same, you know, my eyebrows are blue and all that. Okay. So, get my eyes like this so my eyeliner does not smudge. I'm gonna take, there it is, this brush with Milani and the Tea Rose. Just gonna kinda pat it on right above my contour line and just kinda brush it out. I'm gonna pat it on my contour line. Because I'm going for more of a grunge look, I'm not wanting to do, like, my big dramatic goth, drag makeup that I can do for a female look. Because this is more androgynous. And I just noticed one where she was. I just noticed one small issue, and I gotta fix it. Just gonna do this. That looks better. Like, you can't see it, but I can, and I'm like, oh yeah, it looks better. Alright. This is Becca Pearl. Okay. Get all this off me. Excuse me. It is only 10:11. Okay, fast, I got ready. Set my makeup first. So I set that. Grab my makeup bag and I'm going to rub this. There's my liquid liner. I know I just saw it. There you are. I'm gonna grab this and this small brush for anything. I'm gonna grab the Milani and that was a highlight, bro. That was brushy highlighting. Look, I don't have any small powder brushes left, do I? Nope, I need to get some more just for travel. Because all mine are too big. I mean, yeah, I'll just throw that in there for now. So I'm gonna go and grab my shirt that I'm gonna wear. The only problem with the shirt is it's got this in the back and it drives me crazy because I hate it. This was my mom's. Mom was a much bigger person than I am. Bigger boobs and everything. There we go. You know, now I'm looking at it, I'm not sure if I'm liking this. I'm not sure if I'm liking this color. No, the gray just doesn't look right.
Okay, well, let's see.
How does the white, the actually off-white shirt look in comparison? That actually looks better. Okay, so, actually looks better. Let me shift my fucking binder up. Oh. Tuck down. Yeah, I'm wearing a bra and a binder. But if I don't wear the bra, I sweat badly. Alright. Yeah, I like this better because it's got the asymmetrical. Yeah, I like that better. It doesn't look just... It looks a lot different. Especially, you know, and I'm going to put a jacket on after anyway, so... First, let me...
First. There you motherfuckers are. Alright.
That was my shoe. I'm putting on my Docs. I'm doing a grunge song. I'm doing a Negative Nancy by Adore Delano. And the only thing I could do to add to my outfit is wear shorts over this. Just so I had a bit of a barrier between me and my thing. Only problem with... Okay, actually, I'm going to take this wet wipe and wipe off my foot because I got powder all over it. Thank you, fucking, powder. There goes my sock. So yeah. So originally I was just gonna wear the gray top for the grunge, kind of grunge look, because the door is like more recent, like the album of the song that Negative Nancy's off of, is kind of a rocky grunge album. I remember Adore is actually a drag artist, so I use the term drag artist because a lot of times, so yeah. All right. Fuck. I forgot. The leggings are supposed to roll the leg down into the boot, not... And the boot still be up. Have it outside the boot. I keep reading that. There we go. Now I gotta relace the boot. Tying my shoe, and it's a boot, so I can't exactly be on screen to do that. I'm going to attempt to double knot this just so. There we go. Oh. Sorry. My breathing was slightly cut off. It's, even when I have, even when I'm not wearing a binder or any of that, I still have trouble breathing when I bend over like that. Because what I've done is I've compressed all my torso. And so my breathing's kind of cut off Not and even if I weighed less, I'd still suffer from that issue. Shift the sock. So, there we go. Trying to shift everything. Yeah, my binder tucked into my leggings. Which is why I'm thinking maybe I should wear a pair of shorts just to cover up some issue. I put on the shorts because after a while the leggings just, you know, start to feel a little uncomfortable. Okay. These shorts do not have pockets in the front. They have this fake shit. Which is okay, especially if I'm just trying to wear them as, you know, an extra thing. Just an extra little layer of, yeah, like that. God. Whatever, right?
Great. Stomach is not going to cooperate right now. It's not going to be good.
All right.
Come here, you. Come here. That's right, the other one's over here.
Okay. Where's the multicolor brush of... Where's the multicolor? I'm actually a wood brush. What's that? Where's my actual wood brush? Like the thick one. So I gotta brush through this shit. This is my Jareth wig. Is it black, vegan, and Jareth? put.
Kinda need that wig.
Something on there. Oh, those are the wings.
Where the fuck is it?
Alright. So, the good brush is kind of missing. That's a little, it's kind of pissing me off slightly. So that's the good wig brush. And I don't know where it is. No, I didn't remove it from this room. So, because I need to get this brushed out, and I need that brush. Let me go check one of the other rooms.
Oh, hi, Boogie.
Okay. So, that brush is indeed kind of missing. I am not happy about that. Because that's the good wig brush. It's the one that gets through the knots. And I'm a little pissed off now. Because it's missing.
Where the fuck is it?
So, yeah, so my good brush is missing in action, which is weird because, you know, I'm pretty sure I used it yesterday, yeah, I used it Wednesday, you know, because I went to karaoke and I went and cosplay again. I love cosplay. I love doing vegan cosplay. It's fun. But it's not here. Alright, so this one, forgot I had to pull it front to back. Back to front because I have to get around my goddamn hair. You know. Little fucker in the back. Okay. Seriously, have peace. first things first, I gotta hook this into the wig. I have to use the tightest setting because,
unfortunately, I have a very, reality is I don't have a lot of hair anymore. So when I first started wearing this wig, I actually didn't have a lot of hair.
Because I had cut it off. Come on. Get on.
Okay. Now.
I'm gonna carefully... I can actually use this wig for Aizawa from, I need the fucking good brush because this is tangled and I can feel it and it's driving me crazy. Ugh! Where the fuck did it go? Alright. I just gotta make sure I get the angles right. Okay. So now, gonna have to do this. Hard part about this wig is it just does not like to cooperate because it's so big. I'm just trying to separate the fucking. I'm gonna separate these pieces. What I'm trying to do. Separate sections so that I can actually have my ear showing. But this wig is very, very ear covering. And every time I try, come on, come on. There we go. Oh, hello, person who's on here. I don't know. I didn't see who you were. Where are all my fucking small little... Let's see. Excuse you? No. And second of all, I'm not a girl. Ugh. Just because I happen to have tits does not mean I'm a girl.
makes you think it's okay to say shit like that? Fun fact for you, I find body hair on me is personally disgusting. And I'm not into men. So that things are not directly in my eyes. Oh, and they left. Thank fucking God. The nerve of some people. Ew, no, if I could get them. Really? Really, jerk? Really? I am a, one, a drag king, two, I'm wearing a freaking binder. God. Reason number 557 why I'm glad I'm gay. My channel. God. Because you're being disgusting. I do not have to tolerate creepy behavior. No, I won't. Get off my channel if you're going to be a disgusting person. you. Earrings. Oh, good. Did you? Oh, good. He left. Jesus fucking Christ. The fuck is wrong with some people? This isn't fucking Pornhub. If you want to see tits so bad, go to fucking Pornhub. I am so thankful that as someone who likes women, I am not interested in their tits. God. I feel like it'd be refreshing for some of them. It's like, yeah, no, I don't care about your boobs. It's like, yeah, no, not interested, I don't care about, you know. Yeah, boobs are nice, but that's not why I like you. I like you because your personality. And again, I'll probably question any cute-looking girl that's going to be interested in me, because in the past, any person, you know, when it comes to that, it's usually, oh, this is a trap. Case in point of, you know, being bullied growing up. Oh, I actually really love this wig. It's just really annoying to deal with. Let's find that fucking brush. Okay, come on, come on, come on, come on. Yay! So, yeah. I just had two people decide to be creeps, and I don't care about that shit. I'm not into that shit. Okay. Only thing I am going to do is put a little bit of, just take this and just stick it up here so that the split is a bit wider. And it also helps just keep it a little bit more out of my eyes. There we go. There we go. Okay, that's better. One of these days I'll probably buy another Jareth wig and style it and permanently add in extensions and give me a more emo wig. Like the reason I bought this in the first place. Alright, so now to add in some more accessories. First, put on my fake nose ring. Eventually, I will eventually actually get my septum pierced. Looks like I cut myself under my tongue. That's not good. All right. So now I'm gonna add the cuff. Yeah. So I'm a little upset that I've had guys just be creepy on me now. Oh well. I've had people be creepy at other places. Like, there are some places, you know, where you kind of expect it to happen, like fetish parties. Probably because I pass off as a sub. I ain't. It's like, well, because I passed off a sub as a sub, I'm not a sub by a long shot. The only person I would ever consider subbing to anyway is a significant other, and I don't have one of those, mostly because it's not that I'm not looking, it's just finding one that's okay with polyamory is not easy. It would also be okay with doing some of the things I want to do, you know. You know, they'd have to be able to put up with the fact that I do drag. They'd have to be able to put up with my cosplay bullshit, and I enjoy doing couples cosplays, so there's that. I'm gonna add this cuff. Gonna add this. Oop, come on, come on. Thank you. And then I'm gonna add this cuff to here. There we go. Okay. I do like the black gauges. They look cuter. They definitely look cuter and definitely go for more of the emo vibe that I like going for. Alright. Now that that's all done with, time to put on the lips.
Lip liner.
It's Alien by NYX. Oh, there we go. And that goes in the travel bag. And now this one, I'm running out of it. Actually, I think I will open a new one. This is I bought these because Alani only has so many. Alani only comes out with a black one around Halloween, of course. This is Poison Kiss by Blackheart. It's got the little black dot on the top. Carefully lift. Ah, yes. My precious. Yes. The lip line. So that's simple. You just even it out. Actually go back and add some more blush to my face. And lipstick. So I'm gonna take this and go back with my blush brush. This is literally a angled blush brush. I'm gonna add some more to my cheeks. Yes. Oh, I feel so good today. I look so good. I'm so happy. Look so fucking hot. Can't wait to do Negative Nancy. I love Adore. One day I will start doing some of her other songs. I'll do Jump the Gun again someday. That's what I can get a good look for. The only thing you gotta do next is pull hair out of your face. Alright. Un momento. I'm in my jacket. Let's see. Oh, I got an idea. Okay. So, first things first. Let me get my jewelry on. So I got my jacket. This, I have to dry clean this damn thing in order for it not to smell anymore. Oh, hair, you are not cooperating. No, put the wig, I'll put a pin in you. Okay, fine. Guess you need a bigger pin. It's gonna kinda show through. Fucking annoying. What does that? First thing first. Bullet necklace. Second bullet necklace. I'm going to lay off the bones. These are actual real vertebrae, and I don't want to wear them to a bar that I'm going to be performing at and run the risk of losing them. Okay. Now, coffin bracelet on this arm. Actually, I'm just gonna see if I can get them all on my arm. Coffin, Goth Girls Club. I'm actually a demi boy. My pronouns are he, him, they, them. If you were someone who knows me in real life, then yes, you could refer to me by female pronouns. But typically, don't. It upsets me. Like, if I don't know you in real life, I don't want you using female pronouns on me. Because that's just offensive. Alright, so I got all my bracelets. This one's a heart. Music Newton Hearts. It says, Dear Music, Take Me Anywhere. These say Goth Girls. Goth Girls Club, and this one, and these two are skulls. So, thanks. Let's see. I could wear this, but I know it'll come off. Yep. Ain't doing it. I've already lost a ring there once. Like, ain't doing that again. Just really, really fucking upsetting that some jackasses decide to come on here and make really rude and sexual comments to me. Like, the sexual comments, it's just the way they do it, you know? So.